Hour, and I'm your host, Dr. Business, coming at you through WDRB Media and WGIV, the soul of Charlotte. I'm here at the Love and Laughter Tour with Mr. Woods.
Once again.
He's in the house.
We meet once again.
That's right, sir. Yeah. You are all over the place. You are the man.
I try.
Superstar. Extraordinaire. Infamous in all your ways.
Something like that. Yeah, man. But we out here, Evans Auditorium, the Love and Laughter. Just got off the stage, man. The crowd was great. They loved me, man. It was phenomenal, man.
Great energy.
I actually came out on, I did a tribute to B.I.G. Big Papa came out on that. You know, being that, you know, they have Faith Evans in the building, Total, the Bad Boy crew. So I had to show love to B.I.G., man.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yep.
You always represent. Always looking at. Always giving shout out.
I gotta do what I do, man. I gotta pay homage. Right. I mean, B.I.G., absolutely. Like, he's the reason why I'm here. He's one of my favorite artists that I've looked up to. He inspired me to rap. So it was a lovely thing to do that for him today.
How important is energy when you're on stage and you're performing, the energy that you get from the crowd?
The energy that comes back from the crowd for me, like, once I know the crowd is feeling what I'm doing, it just takes me to a whole nother level, because I'm real passionate about performing. Mm-hmm. That's my thing. I mean, I love doing music, but the other side of it is the performance side of it, and just to see the energy from the crowd and the feedback, it just does wonders to me, man. I just love it.
Because you've been entertaining for how long now?
I've been doing over 15 years.
Over 15 years?
Yeah, I actually been on tour with Keisha Cole, Kanye West, Fantasia. So I've been in arenas where there's 10,000 people in arenas, and just seeing the energy out there, man, it just, words can't describe.
That's absolutely incredible. Yep. Mm-hmm. You at the top of your game, sir?
Not yet. I'm trying to get there. I'm working my way up. You got to crawl before you walk.
And where do you see yourself then? A year from now? 2 years from now?
Overseas.
Okay.
Right now I'm working on some international music. I like EDM music. So overseas, doing internationally, because I got a broad spectrum of music. Mm-hmm. So I feel myself going overseas and traveling internationally.
And when you say overseas, is there any place in particular that you want to make sure that you go
everywhere. UK definitely is the first stop.
Okay.
And we just take it from there. You know, we take it out of the country, man. Because my music is abroad, like I said, really broad. It's worldly. Mm-hmm. And I'd want to touch people all across the world. So I definitely want to travel and see myself just traveling all the time with the music.
Would you give that type of advice for people that are in the industry? Because sometimes they pigeonhole themselves and their music is not broad, therefore they'll never get the opportunity to tour overseas.
Absolutely. When I write music, I don't write music just for one type of genre of music. I write music for all types of genres. And once you do that and you create that kind of music, you're able to go anywhere across the world. So that's what I do. When I write these songs, I want to do it for the world. I'm not just doing it for the urban market or, you know, just one type of market. I want to do it for all types of markets, all types of genres, and just tell people all across the world. So I make my music very worldly and broad, something that everyone can relate to. Everybody can understand where Woods is coming from. So
now, from your perspective, what's the difference between rap and hip-hop?
Rap, anybody can put words together to make the words rap.
Okay.
Now, hip-hop is a lifestyle. No, it is. Hip-hop is a lifestyle.
Right.
I mean, that's what it is. You know, I grew up on hip-hop. B.I.G., Jay-Z, Big Daddy Kane. It goes on and on. List goes on and on. Nas, Escobar. Like, these are hip-hop artists. Like, and it was a culture. You know, it was a movement. And that's what I grew up on, and that's what I want to continue to present to the world, because a lot of days, like right now, a lot of people just rapping, a lot of people not bringing the culture, but we got to stick to the culture and bring that back again. Mm-hmm. That's what I think is lacking. So when I do this album, CEO, Conquered Every Obstacle, I feel like that's going to be
CEO,
Conquered Every
Obstacle.
Yes, that's the name of my album.
Wow.
Self-titled, and working on it, man. It's going to be a hip-hop album. So
And it's going to drop when?
Later on in the year, probably in the fall of 2015.
Okay.
We'll be working on that. I want to drop an EP, Blood, Sweat, and Years, sometime in spring, and then hopefully at the end of the year, we'll be able to drop the album. So
that's phenomenal.
I just dropped a video this week on YouTube. It's called They Don't Really Know.
They Don't Really Know.
Featuring Charnell.
Okay.
It's on YouTube. Go check that out.
Absolutely.
The single is on iTunes. It's available on iTunes.
Okay.
And you know, that song is actually about, you know, when you walk around and people see you and you get judged every day, people don't know. They don't know your story. They see where you're at, but they don't know how you got there. So they don't really know. It's something that I think we all can relate to. There's a video that I think a lot of people should go check out and just get the concept from it. And, you know, I think everybody's going to love it.
Absolutely. Yeah. And then when it comes out, the Grammys next year.
Oh, the Grammys. I'm definitely getting the Grammy. Yeah, exactly. I'm going to get a Grammy.
Absolutely.
The Grammy is mine.
That's right.
I'm claiming it.
That's right.
It's Mr. Woods. So it's going to be my first Grammy. And I'm going to be like, I told Dr. about the business.
Right.
About the business. You
that's
know
right.
what I'm saying? So when I get that Grammy.
Can I run up on stage with
oh, absolutely.
Entourage
I'm like,
Doc, and stuff,
I'm like Dr.
And
business.
Be
come
in the
on.
Back and,
come on up, man. Let's work on
the
Dr. business.
Distract the pose and whatnot. You know,
absolutely. It's not a problem.
I just want to get your vapors. That's
it's all love. It's all love. I got nothing but love for this. You know what I'm saying? So
absolutely.
Yep.
Family, Mr. Woods,
yep.
Here on the mic, always on the mic, the consummate entertainer. Be sure you check him out, iTunes, YouTube, all over the internet, download his stuff, watch for his projects, go to his concerts. He's blowing up. Absolutely.
Yeah.
You heard it here, the Profit and Growth Hour, with your man, Dr. Business, on WDRB Media, WGIV, the soul of Charlotte.
Yeah.
We want to thank today's guests for joining us and providing us such wonderful insight. Thank you, PNG family, for tuning in. Continue to tune in to the Profit and Growth Hour every day, 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, from 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. and from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Please remember to get a copy of my new book release entitled Birthing the Greatness Within. You can always go to www.drbusiness.com and order your copy today. That's drbizness.com. Also remember to connect with me at info@drbusiness.com or call me at 877-342-7770 or hit me up at Facebook and Twitter at Dr. Business BD, standing for Business Doctor, or connect with me on LinkedIn at Dr. Business. I am Dr. Business, and you're listening to the Profit and Growth Hour. Until we meet again, I pray that you prosper and be in health just as your soul prospers. We're out.
Do you have a business or nonprofit organization that's in need of direction? Give Profit and Growth a call at 877-342-7770. That's 877-342-7770. Their goal is to diagnose the symptoms stopping your business from getting to the next level. Call 877-342-7770. That's 877-342-7770. Or log on to drbusiness.com. That's drbizness.com.